We have just announced an extraordinary gift, a gift of £100 million to support research in antimicrobial resistance.
The antimicrobial resistance is one of these hidden sort of dangers for the human race. I don't think it's widely recognized yet.
If this pandemic has taught us anything, it is the importance of not ignoring high consequence events that are headed our way.
COVID-19 has been like an earthquake. So it's been rapid, sudden, whereas antimicrobial resistance, you can't see it, you can't feel it, but nonetheless, it's increasing year on year.
Clinical practice has been maintained by commonplace use of antibiotics. And in fact, there's rather few classes of antibiotics, approximately half a dozen or so that are really important. All of those are compromised by resistance mechanisms now.
And if that becomes widespread, then we will return to what is only referred to as the pre-antibiotic era, where a simple urinary tract infection or a simple cut led to death. And I think it's our job to make sure that the unthinkable doesn't become the inevitable.
Penicillin was first turned into a workable medicine right here in Oxford.
So you've got that history here and probably the best medical research you can find worldwide.
So it seems entirely fitting that we should again be at the vanguard of studying antimicrobial resistance.
The donation will provide us with a critical mass of people, because this has not been a fashionable field to fund, both from academia and industry, for some period of time.
So when a generous donation as such is made, especially for academia, it's an encouragement and improvement of the infrastructure to do research on it.
One of the exciting parts of this collaboration with a very successful business is that we hope that they will help us translate this primary research.
And this will enable us to do work on antibiotics that we've been dreaming about doing for the past couple of decades.
It will allow us to design novel drugs to use in animals, because at the moment we've got this ridiculous situation where we're using human antibiotics as animal growth promoters. It will allow us to have a program to design novel drugs for human medicines.
And we believe the best way to do that is by providing an outstanding basic science environment that encourages and nurtures young people to make basic science discoveries.
The constructive feedback that goes in quickly from the chemist to biochemist back to chemist. So, you know, it's a whole process of making it efficient and exchanging dialogues and ideas.
We have an education and a communication program, AMR courses, international fellowships, etc., but also that we can have some engagement on international policy.
So we're absolutely delighted to have this opportunity to harness the range and depth of expertise in Oxford in this area, so that we can not only do cutting-edge research, but as importantly, translate that research for human benefit.
It doesn't get much worthier than helping save the human race, really, does it? You know, it's a pretty worthy cause, and off we go.